Herzlich willkommen zu einer neuen Ausgabe vom SE Talk. Ich bin jetzt bei Canasil, bei mir ist der CEO und ja, wir sprechen eigentlich wie immer um die letzten Dinge. Bama, thank you to have you here. Hopefully the microphone is working. First time that we use this in this way.
Pleasure, Joe.
Coming up, 2013 was really a bad year for the resource market. And also, when I look at it, your share price, it was the first half year was a disaster. But you're going forward and build your company. And maybe you can give us a rough overview what you're doing in the last 12 months, also in these bad times.
Certainly, yeah. 2013 was a very difficult year for the resource industry, as we all know. There was a move away from the resource sector into the main market, so everything was depressed. The producers, the large companies, small companies, worst hit of all the junior explorers like ours. Main driver was that gold and silver were down approximately 30% over the year. And most of that fall took place in the first 3 or 4 months of the year. And at that time, our share price took a steep drop from around 15 cents down to around 5 cents. But then after that, it stabilized. And what we were really focused on during this period was to try to finalize some option and joint venture agreements on our projects, because when the share prices are low, that's the best way of non-dilutive financing of work. And of course, we were looking for some serious companies to work with who are well-financed, who are well-recognized, who are highly reputable. And we're very pleased that we concluded an agreement with MAG Silver on our Salamandra project and in May of 2013. And since that time, the share prices slowly started moving up, also helped by a little bit more interest in the resource sector, particularly at the end of the year. And although the gold and silver prices have been low, they've been stable in the second half at that low level.
Before we come to outlook, you tell us before that Canasil has really always a good relationship to the silver price. So what was normal relation from the silver price to the share price of Canasil?
We have a very high leverage to the silver price because we have 10 predominantly silver-focused exploration projects in Mexico in particular. And traditionally, there was approximately a 5 to 10 times leverage to the silver price. So for example, for a 20% increase in the silver price, you would see at least 100% increase or a doubling of the Canasil price. This didn't take place in 2013 because the whole sector was depressed, but generally we see very high fluctuations with the silver price.
Okay, then silver price is a good word. What is your expectation about the silver in general?
I think the outlook for silver is good, and many analysts think that it may even be better than gold. Traditionally, you monitor the ratio of gold to silver price, and in 2011, in March of 2011, when silver hit a peak price of $49, at the time the ratio was about 1 to 35. Mm-hmm. Gold was about 1,750, 1,800. Right now, the ratio is about 1 to 60. The silver prices are $20 and the gold prices are $12.50. So going from 1 to 35 to 1 to 60, even if this comes back to a more normal level around 1 to 45 or 1 to 50, it still means a higher upside potential for silver than for gold. I think the prices may end up not having a dramatic increase in 2014, but certainly silver, because it's also an industrial commodity, has a lot of industrial uses. The general forecast is very positive for the silver price in 2014.
Okay, coming to this year, what are the plans for 2014?
I hope 2014 is going to be a much more positive year. We are certainly starting off very well with the joint venture with MAG Silver. They right now have a 3,000 meter drill program on our Salamandra project. It's a very large silver, copper, zinc project in very close to the city of Durango in Mexico, extremely well located. It's on trend and very close to one of the largest silver, copper, zinc mines in Mexico, the San Martin mine. And I know MAG Silver think very highly of the project. They've completed the 1,000-meter drill program already by the end of December. They have another 2,000-meter in progress now. And we hope that we'll have some positive results from that program. And then ongoing drilling that they will continue with, I think, would have significant expenditures on the project and give us some significant results coming. We are also, because we have 10 very well-placed projects, five of them drill-ready in Mexico, we are in discussions, have confidentiality agreements with some good companies, looking at further option and joint venture agreements on some of the other projects. And if we are able to conclude those, that also has the potential for creating significantly more work and more generation of value on our project. So the focus really is to generate some real value on our projects, and I think 2014 has very good prospects for allowing us to do that.
Thank you, Baumann. It was a quick update, and thank you and good luck. Hopefully MAG drill something out and going forward from this.
Great. Thank pleasure, you. Joe. Thanks very much. Thanks for the opportunity.